With Windows 11 finally being official, here is everything you need to know, and we'll start from the most noticeable and end up with the under-the-hood changes you probably wouldn't have noticed.
Do you feel like this when you see this? Well, if so, you can get rid of that Windows activation message with today's video sponsor SCD Keys for as little as $12 USD. After you use that coupon BFTYC, you can get activated today. Links in the description below.
Starting with Microsoft's new visual language, there's an emphasis on glass, I mean semi-transparency, from the rounded corners to the pop-ups, even to the radio buttons. It looks nice. There are new animations for interacting with apps, like maximizing windows, and more noticeable minimize animations too. Though the biggest example is the new start menu. It seems to have switched from a resizable dynamic element to a static element, where the only customizations allowed are the content, the scaling, and the placement. You always have a 6x3 grid of pinned apps at the top, and your recommended section underneath that, which can show you three things: recently installed, most used apps, as well as recently opened files. You can choose which of these three are visible or hidden, but they'll always appear in this section. They don't have their own tabs, and even if you disable all three options, the section will remain with a link to enable them in the settings, which in my opinion is quite lazy programming, but it looks nice, so I won't be too critical. You can't resize the start menu's height, width, or how many icons appear. It always looks the same besides what apps you choose to pin and the color based on your theme and background. Your account options look like this, and your power options look like this. Your programs list is moved over to this button here and now looks like this. You can also have multiple pages of pinned apps. Personally, my favorite is the snaps layouts. All you have to do is hover over the maximize button for a couple of seconds and it will show you a bunch of screen layouts, and then you can click to add your window to one, like the fancy Zones app. The next big change is the addition of widgets. You get a little bit of finance, weather, news, and sports. It's customizable in terms of size and placement, and what you see is based on MSN. But that's not even the worst part. You actually need to be logged into your Microsoft account to even enable them, which is a big no-no. I do not support Microsoft locking down features to people who log in. In fact, I appreciated the fact that you could completely use Windows 10 without a Microsoft account, with the exception of the Windows paid store apps like Forza and HVAC Codecs. But Forza is on Steam now and you can just use VLC, so you could feasibly use the PC without any logging in. Forcing a Microsoft account increases unstoppable telemetry, requires a password login, and is just a bunch of hassles. So when it says continue with limited experience, if you don't need an MSN feed, you won't have a limited experience at all. But in better news, there is no more forced Cortana. Rejoice! The Cortana app remains, but the Windows setup and taskbar are not using it anymore. The search option remains, but as always, you can just start typing in the start menu, so the search button is redundant for people with muscle memory. Speaking of useful voice assistants, unlike Cortana, Microsoft implemented native multiple voice assistant support, which will allow voice assistants besides Cortana to function natively in Windows. I think you can already set up Alexa to a small extent, but seeing the Google Assistant right on the taskbar would be very appreciated. Being able to control smart lights or play music with Google Voice would actually be the one use case I would use a voice assistant on the PC for, besides asking stupid questions and seeing how they answer.
According to Circle Care, the banana plant and herbaceous plant, not a tree, because the stem does not contain true woody tissue. That's why bananas are not technically a fruit, but it's an herb.
Maybe I'm getting too far ahead of myself. I mean, this is Microsoft after all. If you have multiple physical monitors, Windows will try to place apps in more natural places and reset them when you reconnect or disconnect secondary monitors. Speaking of monitors, if yours is HDR, then Windows will take a feature from Xbox and attempt to convert SDR content into HDR content, but they still haven't fixed the washed out look on 8-bit HDR certified panels like my LG B7 and the Aegon Super Ultra Wide here in the studio, even though the panels have 800 nits and 400 nits respectively. On the topic of Xbox features, the Direct Storage API requires an NVMe SSD to boost gaming performance. Windows will copy files from the RAM to the GPU memory. This is similar but different to NVIDIA's implementation, which features a game API telling the GPU to load files directly from the SSD to GPU memory and decompress them without utilizing the CPU at all. Keeping with gaming, Windows 11 has native support DirectX 12 Ultimate API, although I'm pretty sure Windows 10 already had this feature as a feature of a previous update, and this becomes a little bit of a theme with Windows 11. Microsoft describes brand new features, and they have already been implemented into Windows 10. Two examples of this is spatial sound support and Wi-Fi 6E support. In the way of native things though, Microsoft has stopped including Skype, 3D Viewer, and Paint 3D on new installs, but they're still available from the Microsoft Store. Speaking of, they have introduced a new store. You can now search and install Android apps like TikTok and have them run on Windows without an emulator. Another feature is alleged ability to install Android app packages, also known as APKs, but again, this functionality wasn't working in our dev copy. However, a new installer that is working on our build is the Winget Package Manager, which allows you to install an app with no hassles. It's kind of satisfying. You can use Winget Search to find programs in public CDNs and Winget Install to download and install without a single click in most cases. Speaking of command lines, Windows is transitioning to the new Windows Terminal, which is a single app that allows you to run PowerShell, Command Prompt, and even Linux subsystems. It's seamless and looks very modern. It allows multiple tabs. Overall, very nice. Windows 11 feature updates will be released once per year instead of quarterly and will still receive monthly quality updates. Tablet mode has been replaced with S mode, apparently, and it's a whole new edition of Windows, which only runs Windows Store apps, but even more importantly for touch devices running Windows 11, a swipe keyboard. Finally, Microsoft has also removed a few features that nobody ever used, or should have used, like Internet Explorer, the app and file history timeline, and the wallet, really begging the question of, why did Windows ever have these things in the first place? Windows also has a new setup menu, or an out-of-the-box experience if you prefer. Finally, we have a few changes to finish up. Hardware scheduling is enabled by default. Big little CPUs seem to be properly optimized. You can move the taskbar to the left, so it's not forced to be in the middle if you don't like that. The search menu will try and add experiences to the search, like if you search for the weather or calculator. New sounds in Windows, very soft and zen. New wallpapers, new Windows logo, new icons, added padding in Windows Explorer by default, and finally moving over more web executables to Microsoft Edge and Edge View 2. Teams is now Edge View based instead of Electron based. Electron is Chromium based. Anyway guys, that is all the features and differences between Windows 11 and Windows 10. This is sort of like a change log, and do let us know in the comments section below, did we miss anything? And also, let us know in the comments, what is your favorite difference between Windows 11 and Windows 10? Besides the different ways Microsoft is going to get telemetry enabled. But I'm pretty sure that's going to be nobody's favorite thing, just like Internet Explorer. And with all that out of the way, if you've stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes content, then be sure to hit that like button for us. And also, if you've stayed this far and you're enjoying that content, then be sure to hit that sub button. Ring that bell to get the content as soon as it drops here at Tech Yes City. And I'll catch you in the next one very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.